This is a real 90 seconds this time.
Yeah.
Yeah. That one was a test. This monitor is not working for my time. Timer and monitor, yeah. There we go. Yes, he's rushing down right now. So I'll bring Derek on.
So I'm going to put this towards you.
Yeah, yeah. Which should be towards me anyways, right? Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And then when he pops in, we'll bring him in. Probably second segment is what it looks like. I'll carry Derek, and if Dyer Annals starts texting me. Oh, yeah. Cool. Sounds good. We're on Facebook. I was just warned. We're on Facebook Live. We're going to be starting here in just a moment. Get ready. It's Business Leaders Live. We've been gone for a while. Good deal. Thank you. All right. We'll be on here in a moment. I love that squeaky door. Saddle again right here on Talk Radio 1680 KGED. It's Business Leaders Live with yours truly, Lance Cardoza. We've been gone for about 3 weeks. We took some time spending with family. Woody said he went and took advantage of the three-suit deal. Woody back here, engineer, he went down to the Fresno Suit Outlet and treated himself to that nice three-suit deal with my buddy Big Tony. So went in there. Big Tony wasn't there, but there was a lot of suits that could fit Big Tony. So they have everything that fits all sizes, and they have that incredible three-suit deal. A little plug for my friend during the holidays or just outside of the holidays. They're probably regrouping. But all retail is regrouping and getting back in the swing of things. We're getting back into business, and we're getting ready to go. And coming up, and everybody every year that has attended a hot stove, so a Fresno Grizzlies hot stove, a hot stove event is a gala event. It's a great event, bringing back some of the players from the past, players that have made a mark in the business of sports. And they come back, and you get to just have a Q&A, talk with them, and be able to see what makes them tick and their journeys and their life stories. And during that time, it's always a great time. There's also local athletics that are recognized, so at a hot stove. And the hot stove is just, it's an amazing an event. And from what I understand, and I was talking to a buddy of mine, Dan Taylor, former ABC 30 sports broadcaster. He was talking about the hot stove. The guys would gather around a hot stove, and they would share stories and talk in those old wood-burning stoves, and that's where the term hot stove came from. And they would talk about the sport they all love. So on the phone, and we will have team dentist of the Fresno Grizzlies, Dr. Jared Mosley. He's on his way, stuck in traffic right now, but he'll be here momentarily. He's probably listening from his car on the big dial 1680 and listening to us there. But I have the president and part owner of the Fresno Grizzlies, Derek Franks, on the phone. Derek, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, Lance. Good morning.
Good morning. So, Derek, did the holidays treat you okay?
Holidays were great. Yes, we had a fantastic time with family, and as many know, the Grizzlies, we close our office down for the time between Christmas and New Year's. So, nice little break for the staff, as you know, we're 98 days to opening day, and a race to April 14th for the home opener of the Fresno Grizzlies season. So, for the staff, it's a nice little. A little break, and now we hit the ground running to get all the last preparations for baseball season done.
It's right around the corner. You know, it's going to be right now is the day that one of those two or three days that you put gloves on in the Central Valley. And I'm thinking about it. It's going to be nice and warm, and we'll be coming into April 14th, and that's opening day of the Fresno Grizzlies, like you said, and it's almost here already.
It'll be here before we know it. I know everybody's thinking about football right now, but just a few weeks from now, literally, we'll be really focused on baseball as people are, the players are getting ready to report to spring training in late February, and it'll be here before we know it.
I have the head coach. I wanted to give our listeners a little overview of today's show. I have the head coach of the Monsters also coming on here. Trevor just came in here in July. He'll be coming in later in the program. And I have our team dentist, as you well know, Derek, Dr. Mosley, a great friend of the Fresno Grizzlies. He'll be in here momentarily. And we're talking about Hot Stove. And the Hot Stove event, like I was saying before I brought you on, players used to gather around a hot stove, a burning hot stove, right, and share stories about the sport. Is that how the name Hot Stove was coined?
Yeah, that, and I think it also refers to the fans, also during the winter months, sitting around the hot stove, talking about the moves and the trades and the things that their favorite team was doing as well. I think that's what I've always loved about baseball is, even though, it's a long off season, it feels like a long off season. I think it's the sport with the most activity as far as free agents and trades and things that keep you interested in the game. And so that old hot stove, sitting around one of those potbelly stoves, talking about, telling baseball stories, following your favorite team and the moves that they're going to make in anticipation of the following season. It's one of the great, great traditions of baseball.
So we also, Derek, we recognize many people from the past, and I think, and I'm not sure, Woody, if you can hear me in the control room, but is that Mr. Miller on the line? So you remember when we had the Astros, we had the pitching coach, Dyer Miller, that was with the Fresno Grizzlies, a good friend of the Grizzlies, and Derek, you would say, probably one of the most, iconic guys that have rolled through Fresno, and is just very memorable and just a great guy for the players.
Oh, absolutely. Dyer's certainly one of those players' coaches and just a great, great person to be around. I learned a lot of being around Dyer when he was here in Fresno and heard a lot of great stories about the game of baseball he has been a part of for many, many decades and accumulated a lot of great stories and a lot of great interactions, run-ins, and competitive moments with some great names in baseball history. So Dyer's he's forgotten more about baseball than most of us know, I think.
Yeah, I'm sure. And Woody, I don't know if we can join both of them on the line. We can't, but we're going to switch over to Dyer here shortly, Derek. But if you'll stay with us, because I'd like to bring you back after the commercial break real quick here. But I'd like to bring on Dyer Miller. He's going to be recognized at this year's Hot Stove. And this is one of the things last year and I think the year before I told Derek several times that I'd love to see this man recognized or an award with his name on it. And I know that Todd and Dr. Mosley and the group of the advisory board all echoed that same sentiment and agreed. And I know we're going to be having Dyer Miller at this year's Hot Stove. I think he's a fantastic man. He's on the phone right now. Dyer, how are you doing today?
Hey, I'm great. It's good. We got good weather here in Indianapolis, about 50 degrees, so that's good.
Hey, that's a warm day in Indianapolis.
It is. Yes, it is. But I can't wait to get to Fresno. I miss that place.
And then you have some real good weather here.
yeah, you're right.
Dyer, in your career in baseball, Derek said that you have probably forgotten more about baseball. You've been in this business your whole life. I mean, I remember you sharing stories about Buck and Hay as a kid working on the farm, but your professional career has been baseball.
It has. I was fortunate, wanted to be a baseball player when I was 7, and I wound up getting 51 years as a coach and a player in the game. So I'm one of the lucky guys around. The Lord has blessed me. So I enjoy it. I still enjoy it. Kind of miss it a little bit. You know, I miss the people. You know, the nice fans there in Fresno and all the people in the front office. And that's what I miss the most about it.
And at the end of the month here in January, you'll be back here in Fresno. And we'll have Dr. Mosley, the team dentist, coming on the show here shortly.
Right.
He'll be popping in studio. But we'll be talking about the hot stove and how people can get tickets and come down and you're going to be able to see some of the administration and some of the fans and the season ticket holders that will all be coming around there, in the business of baseball, you've seen it change over the years, and we just got a couple minutes here. Where is baseball going? It's a game of numbers. It's always been a game of numbers, but the technology in baseball today is incredible. What they do, and I've watched you work with pitchers before, and can you share a little bit about that? How the direction of baseball is going today?
Well, there's no question it has changed. You know, I coached 34 years, and you know, we went through stages where we started using a radar gun on every pitch, then we used video, then we went to computers to do our game reports, and you know, each one of those things ran some of the old timers out of the game. You know, a lot of people aren't, you know, don't like new things. So I hung around through all that, and this new technology that's coming on, all the data that they use and so forth, it's really very interesting. But you know, I'm in a stage of my career that I don't dislike the technology. It's changed the game a lot. There's no question about it. The stat, they use a lot of different stats, you know, ERAs and all kinds of things aren't as important as they used to be. But I guess it's good. You know, I think it's good. The young people seem to like it, and I think it's been pretty good for the game.
It's good for the game. I think the young people that are coming in, you're coaching, it gives them an opportunity to look at that technology, but really go down to grassroots where it all starts. Dyer, I appreciate it. I know you're busy today. Thank you for calling in. We're going to go take a short break. We'll be right back with Derek Franks.
Okay.
Thanks again.
I look forward to seeing everybody on the 31st. Thanks.
We'll see you on the 31st. Dyer Miller, okay. Major League player and a coach here at Fresno. We'll be right back with more business leaders. All right. Facebook, thank you for staying with us right here on Facebook. Make sure you share it, you comment, you like it. Right here on Talk Radio 1680 KGED. Every Tuesday morning at 9 a.m., I bring you business leaders live, and we have a guest in studio. We talk to the guest, and we've had Dr. Jared Mosley, team dentist of the Fresno Grizzlies.
So we're not on Facebook Live.
Oh, we're not on Facebook Live.
No,
okay, we don't have to worry about it. Okay, cool. All right.
See, we started 5 minutes early. Thought I figured
everything
it out.
Falls apart.
But it's
Mosley should be running in any minute. And then we have Derek still on the line?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So then he can cover for me until... What's that?
He just wanted to make sure he didn't repeat anything that Dyer said.
Oh, okay. He's not listening to the radio?
No. That's what he said. He wanted to hear it on the phone.
Got it.
Probably have 2 minutes.
I don't know where he'll go. Maybe park in the back or whatever, but yeah, maybe leave a door open. He'll be panicked and running. He said he's here. Yeah. My guy's headed to the back to see if he can open the door for you. Oh, there he is. Don't worry. You're good. Come on in.
Good.
Go ahead. Yeah, have a seat right there. We'll be coming back here in a moment.
Oh, good.
Sit right in.
How's it going?
This mic, you talk sideways into it.
Okay.
So you just pull it up just a little bit, and you'll
okay.
be good.
Who have we had on and all that?
Dyer just came off down the air. Talked for about 2 minutes.
Good stuff, like you always do. Derek is on the line.
Yeah. I can lean into it.
Tip this up just a little bit. Where are we on time? We good?
Oh, there we go.
Pick this up.
How do you get that to stay up there, Woody? Maybe lean it towards him, or... Extend it out.
I can lean into it.
Oh, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah, this cord's tight.
It is.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, just like that. And I hear you good over here.
Okay.
So we talked to Derek, talked a little bit about it. We haven't gotten into the details. No weeds of the hot stove.
No, we
got into the weeds of it. So we'll, once we get Derek off, and then we'll go into like the car and all that stuff.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe I should turn my cell phone.
Yeah. Sorry about that. I thought you knew you were coming down. Yeah. Oh, it was light. I was like, oh no, we won't be able to take him on the call. 15 seconds.
You got it. Derek is on the phone.
Yeah, Derek's on. I'll talk with Derek for a moment, and then we'll bring you in.
are listening to Business Leaders with Lance Cardoza, the behind-the-scenes story of the business shakers and movers in the Valley and beyond. Once again, here's Lance Cardoza.
Welcome back, everybody. Every Tuesday morning at 9 a.m., I bring you Business Leaders Live, and we were on a hiatus. We started the show with Aerosmith back in the saddle again, and that's what I felt like. You know, we've been out for about 3 weeks. So I forgot how to things go here, you know. So we're getting it ironed out and ready to go. And I love sports. And I love Fresno. And I know we're talking about the hot stove. We have president of the Fresno Grizzlies, Derek Franks, on the line. Just joined us in studio. We have Dr. Mosley. He's the team dentist of the Fresno Grizzlies. And Dr. Mosley, thank you for being in studio.
Lance, thank you for having me.
And no problem. President Derek Franks is on the line. We're talking a little bit about hot stove. And I think Derek, he hit the nail on the head. I was talking about players would sit around a hot stove. That's how they had this gala, this event. But it was really, it was like fans probably sat around the hot stove and they listened on the radio to their favorite players and games. And they talked about baseball. They talked about their favorite sport. And Derek, are you with us still on the line? Derek, are you there?
Yes. Yeah.
He's probably
I am still with you guys. Yep.
Are you wrangling kids, Derek? So, Derek, president of Fresno Grizzlies, we're talking about hot stove and just really its origin, how it started on January 31st here at the in the event is where, Dr. Mosley?
It's going to be at Chichansey Ballpark.
Right where we play. That's a beautiful thing. And there's some great talents going to be at this year's hot stove. When we talk about players of the past, Derek, over the years with Hot Stove, you've seen a lot of players. You're a fan of the game, and you've seen some of your favorite players grace a Hot Stove and come through. Talk about the experience. What is it like at a Hot Stove event, Derek?
Yeah, the experience is awesome. And my first experience as a Hot Stove attendee was long before I was a baseball front office guy. And I remember years ago going to Bakersfield and seeing they have a wonderful hot stove down there that's been put on for a number of years. And last year came full circle for me. One of the first hot stoves I went to as a kid featured Dave Stewart. I was a fan of the Dodgers when I was growing up, and so I got to see Dave Stewart, meet him, get a baseball card signed by him, and come full circle. He was our featured guest last year. And in the time that I saw him as a former player to last year, he had accomplished so much more in the game of baseball. And so when you come as a fan and you get to come to this wonderful event, you really get to hear the inside locker room stories, the inside baseball perspective, and it is just, as a baseball fan, it's so interesting to get to hear these intimate stories about these players and sports executives and anybody that you followed. You love to hear the inside story, and a lot of laughs and a lot of hilarious ones to boot. So.
To add to the laugh, this is when you said Dave Stewart, and I think we'll all remember. I was at this hot stove. It was, I think, Warner's Theater.
Right.
He talked about Tommy Lasorda, and when you were in trouble or it was something good, Tommy Lasorda, the manager, notorious manager for the Dodgers, he was just incredible. He would call you into the restroom while he was sitting on the can, and he would get your attention, and either you were in trouble and you listened fast and you got out of there, or he was telling you something good or just asking about just whatever, and you'd listen to everything he said because you wanted to get out of that bathroom as soon as you can. But he'd have his meetings in the bathroom. So I saw Steve Garvey this year. Derek, you were at this event. It was Fresno Economic Development Corporation. It was the speaker there. And I went up to Steve, and I said, hey, is it true that Lasorda held his real important meetings in the gym? And he said, who told you that? I said, Dave Stewart. And he goes, oh, it was terrible. It was terrible. So you get those fun, crazy stories. You get all that inside, like you're almost a part of the team, and you get to live some of those experiences. Dr. Mosley, you've experienced several hot stoves.
Oh, yeah.
You're looking forward to this one.
This is going to be big. This is going to be big. We've got... can I say it? Will Clark coming?
Yeah.
Yeah, Will's coming. We've got Steve Yeager
Derek,
coming.
Can we say it? You're the boss.
Can we say it?
Yeah. Heck, I want people to buy tickets, and we got 24 days to go, so yeah, sing it from the rooftop.
That's right.
Will Clark and Steve Yeager, it's going to be a great night.
It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have a couple of guys in attendance that we're not advertising, but George Culver's going to be there.
Awesome.
And he's a longtime baseball guy, and he knows Dyer Miller, so we're going to have a lot of neat conversations. You'll be able to be in them. the middle of it as a fan. Yep. And see him talk, and they'll tell some stories.
Dyer Miller was just on the program, and Dr. Mosley, Derek mentioned about too. What a great guy and a great coach for the players.
Phenomenal.
And like you said, he wants to see the administration. He wants to see some of the people of Fresno. He really connected himself to our community, and I think that shows why he's such a player's coach.
He really is. To be able to be down there and see him up close and personal, you should just see the respect those young guys have for him. And to talk to him, he tells you how it was. You can ask him anything about baseball. What did you like? What's it like eating at Yankee Stadium? What's it like? He'll tell you everything. Tell you the inside of it. And it's a lot of fun. You get to live vicariously through that a little bit.
Exactly. Derek, one of the big things that you're looking forward to this year for the Hot Stove, January 31st, down where the Fresno Grizzlies play in the heart of Fresno, Chichansey Park, what is the big thing you're looking forward to this year's Hot Stove?
Well, I think the return of Will Clark is something that our fans are going to greatly look forward to. We had him pegged for the 2011 Hot Stove, and a lot of our fans will remember he got snowed in trying to get here, and he was stuck in Dallas in a nasty storm, and he never made the event. We ended up the day of or the night before getting in contact with Sergio Romo as a replacement, and so. For our fans, Will Clark came back and did a sort of a makeup event for Hot Stove fans, and some of the folks came back to the ballpark and got to see him. But this will be really great to have him get to do the entire event. And we've actually been in contact with Will the last 3 years to try to get him to come back, and he's expressed a desire to want to come back to Fresno, and it just hadn't worked out. So we're really excited that it worked out this year for him, and he's promised us that our fans will be in store for a lot of great laughs and a lot of great stories. And I know as a former Fresno Giant, there's a lot of affection for Will and his time in Fresno here for Giants fans. And so I think seeing Will Clark and having it back at Chichansey Park on the baseball diamond, I think that's going to be special as well.
We're going to talk about some of those details of that with Dr. Mosley, president of the Fresno Grizzlies. Derek Franks, thank you for taking the time out of your busy day and calling in here at Talk Radio 1680 for Business Leaders Live. We always appreciate your time. Thanks, Derek.
Thank you.
Dr. Mosley, we were talking about some of those details.
Yes.
I think you just showed me a name that's also part of the list.
I'm going to contact him, yeah.
You're going to contact him. What's coming up?
We can't talk about that. He must be watching right now. Yeah, he must be watching.
You haven't talked about it yet. But right now, details about how someone can access tickets to January 31st to be able to be a part of this fun, exciting event, the Hot Stove. How do they do that?
Easy. Just go online to FresnoGrizzlies.com and you can sign up there. You can get your tickets there or stop by the stadium.
There's also Toyota.
Toyota, amazing.
Done some great stuff for this event.
Yes. You've got an opportunity to win a Toyota Hybrid, a Corolla 2020. You can buy a ticket at the gate, and while you're here, and it's cost effective for you to buy it. Believe me, you got a chance of winning a car.
A chance of winning a car, and starting off 2020 right with a brand new 2020 Toyota Corolla, and you have that opportunity to win that. Other prizes too, also.
Oh yeah, there'll be other things. But there. Yes.
But great stuff, and that's January 31st this year at Chichansey Park. It's coming back home on the diamond. Sort of paint a picture. How is that going to be on the diamond?
Well, we're going to do it in the infield. Okay. And the way I've seen it set up so far, we're going to have a nice big tent in case of weather. We're going to protect that. And we're going to have some heaters out there. And we're going to have a stage. And we'll have some tables. And everybody will be able to sit around and listen and have a good dinner. And
it's like a real hot stove.
It's a real hot stove.
Exactly. I love it. And Will Clark, like Derek was saying, he had an issue in the past, and so he's coming back. It's sort of like a double makeup, and those Giants fans of the Valley will be able to go see Will Clark. And Will Clark will be right there in the diamond, the Fresno Grizzlies, which is Chichansey Park on January 31st. You can get those tickets by going to FresnoGrizzlies.com or get your table. Yep. Your business can also get a table. There's going to be some great players there. Having a great time telling some stories and really having fun. And they're accessible, too. That's what
they're
I love about this.
You can walk up to them. You can talk to them, and they'll you can ask them anything. It's neat, just sit there and get into the relationships they had in baseball and playing days and whatnot.
Right after this next commercial break, I have the new head coach, Trevor, and Trevor's with the Monsters Hockey Group.
Okay,
so,
yeah,
Trevor,
I know.
They're playing some games down there at Sullivan Arena, so we'll be bringing Trevor on shortly. But Team Dennis to the Fresno Grizzlies, Dr. Mosley on the air right now. How cool is that? To be able to, you work business as a dentist day to day. You're a huge baseball fan, and you've been blessed with being the team dentist of this great organization.
Blessed, that's correct. You know, it's a dream. I mean, it is so much fun. I have a great time doing it. I love doing it. It's neat to be around the ball players. It's you get to know them. You get to know their families. It's a neat environment.
It's very neat. You connect with these players over the years, and some of them come back.
Yeah, we've kept a lot of them. They come back, and Tony D's one of them. He'll be back. I'll be seeing him here in the next week or so.
Tony DeFrancesco, and he's coaching clear on the other side.
He's now the first base coach for the New York Mets, and so he'll stop back in, and we have a good relationship. It's a good time.
He's a great guy. Another good guy. On your jacket right now, you have the American flag with the rings of the Olympics.
Yes, I
do. And I know every year you do mouth guards.
I do.
For Olympics, and you go back and do that. But a lot of the thing that people don't really know, that Dr. Mosley, Dr. Jared Mosley's office, dentist's office, makes mouthpieces.
We do. For sports local, mouth guards for local athletes.
Athletes all over the valley.
And no charge. If you're an athlete, I don't care if you're 99 years old or if you're 5 years old, we'll make you one.
A mouth guard to protect your smile,
protect your smile. Yep.
And you can get that at Dr. Jared Mosley's office, and you offer that. I didn't know you did that, and you were telling me about it.
We make the same one that we'd make an Olympic team member, or if they're in the MLB, whatever. We make the same one.
And when you go to the Olympics, I saw some stuff on social. It's a big operation. You bring a machine that
We bring pretty much everything. Everything has to be brought in. It's all volunteer. We bring it in, and we set up shop. And it's a busy, long 3 or 4 days.
Yeah, a lot of fun.
Oh, it's a kick in the pants, yeah.
Very excited. So you're a big fan of sports.
Love it.
And you're giving back to what you love, what you grew up on. A portion of the proceeds from the hot stove this
year. Yes, this
is
big.
We
need to touch on this. Yeah. A portion of all the proceeds of the hot stove are going to go to restore our Little League fields here in the valley, in Fresno County. There are some fields that are in dire need to be helped, and we're going to go in there and help restore those fields and give those kids a safe playing field. You know, I've been around the valley here and have had the opportunity to go to a lot of these Little League teams and Little League facilities, and they're just not, they don't have enough money.
They're struggling to pay the bills. Yeah.
And the last thing that they, you know, that's on the list is getting some new dirt for the infield or aerating the grass or, you know, leveling the field. And they're doing the best they can, and they're trying to provide a safe place to play. But we're gonna step in, and we're going to help here.
I'm going to give a little love on the radio right now to a gentleman by the name of Jim Kilner. And Jim Kilner listens to the show, and he was the Kings County Fire Chief. And that time, I think he was a captain in fire. And he ran the Little League in Armona Little League.
Oh, yeah.
And a young guy, he got me to umpire because they didn't have an umpire. I actually had to throw my dad out of that game.
You threw your dad out.
Oh, boy. That's a whole show. And then he had me announce. So, Jim Kilner, this is why I'm on the radio today.
This is why
I work and perform and do all that stuff in media, because of Jim Kilner.
Oh, that's good.
When we come back, we have Trevor, the head coach of Monsters Hockey. Thank you so much, Dr. Mosley, for
being on
the show.
Thank you, Lance.
Hot Stove, January 31st. Go to Fresno Grizzlies to get your ticket. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Great.
Thank you.
Sorry.
No.
You're fine.
I think we got it all in.
I think we touched everything.
Yeah, we got it all. Thanks. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay. Hi. Get out of your way.
Can I get a picture of you two real quick?
Oh,
sure.
I always forget.
Do you want to get our show? Because I got a new phone.
Oh, you do? You want to take it? Just send it to me. That's even better yet.
You're good.
Awesome. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Come on in. So, I had a...
Hi, Trevor.
How you doing?
Good.
Nice to meet you. Yeah, the announcers, I was off.
By a lot.
I just one more time for me.
Krasowicz.
Krasowicz. Church.
Yes.
Present.
We're on Facebook Live.
Oh, we are. Facebook Live. So we're actually up?
Yeah, we're up.
We're up right now. Good deal. Big fan of hockey. My daughter, yeah, used to go all the time. It was so busy.
Yeah.
But when my daughter was young, we'd be right on the glass.
Nice.
And the Grizzlies owner at the time used to own the team.
All right.
So I was very involved during that time. When he closes that door, we'll have you scoot over to right in front of that mic, and you don't have to move the mic. Talk into it sideways there.
Okay.
And I'll pick up. Oh, okay, cool. Cool. You texted or email?
I texted it.
Okay.
Did I put these things on?
Yep. Yeah. You can hear us coming in and out of commercial. Can we do two segments?
Okay.
I'll talk. This is Houston Astros when they first came to the Grizzlies. I worked with the team.
Wow.
We won a national championship. 3 years later, they won the World Series. So that was a very, very powerful year because we lost the Giants after 17 years. And community was just to be tied. Wow. Here comes this team, the Astros. They fall in love with them. We win a national championship. We have three more years with them. They win a World Series. We get the Nationals for 1 year, World Series.
Wow.
So we've had four World Series in the stint of the Grizzlies.
Wow.
We're champions.
That's a nice
ring
there.
Yeah, so I was very, very proud of this ring when we got it. It was cool. I did all of marketing, media stuff, and PR.
Nice.
Stuff. Nice. Worked with the team there. And still do. I love the Grizzlies. Love the Monsters. Like I said, my daughter, she would pound on the glass at like 10, 12 years old. I was like, what is up with this kid? Oh, it was fun. We're going to have to go back. I love it.
Yeah, no, it's nice. It's good, especially being back down in Salem there.
Yeah. The environment in that arena is so nice.
Yeah, it's nice. It's huge.
One more time, your last name?
Karazowicz.
Got it.
Giving you the inside story of business leaders in the Valley and beyond. This is Business Leaders with Lance Cardoza.
Hello, everybody. Back in the studio here at Talk Radio 1680 KGED. I have the head coach of the Fresno Monsters Hockey in studio, Trevor Karazowicz. I blew it. I almost had it.
That's close enough.
Close enough. And Trevor, you came to the Valley here in July. You came over the summer.
Yep.
And where did you come from when you came to
New York?
New York.
Yeah.
So you came from that weather where you have all four seasons, and then you came to Fresno in July and thought, oh, my.
Yeah, second day here, there was an earthquake, so it was all new to
me. Oh, I was producing a Fresno Grizzlies game during that time.
Yep.
When we had that earthquake, the stadium rocked, and my broadcasters bounced. They just left.
Yeah, I know. I almost left, too. It was new to me.
It's new to you.
Yeah.
First time ever experiencing an earthquake.
Definitely.
So, and you saw it's not that bad. You know, it could be devastating in some areas.
I think I'd rather deal with that than the cold, so
yeah,
that's what it is.
Exactly. It's everywhere you are, there's always something. Fresno hockey is, we were just talking about before we went on the air, Monsters Hockey at Selden Arena. My daughter and my youngest one and my oldest one, we'd go to games all the time, and we loved it. We'd sit down there on the glass, and my youngest daughter, Zoe, who I've talked about her, and I've had her on the show, a little monster would come out in her. She would be on that glass, pounding on that glass and getting all fired up. And it was so cool as a dad to see her just get so into it.
Yeah, hockey brings the best out of everybody.
It does. And you just become, you release all that built up, pent up anger from the day. Maybe your day was rough or you just want to release something. Go to a hockey match
and just have
a good time.
Brings out the passion in everybody.
Yeah, just have a good time. Yell and scream, laugh, and have fun. Every sport there's something about it, but that was the one for me with my family, sitting down there in the glass and being a part of that. Monsters Hockey, for a stint, went over and played at Gateway Center and has been playing there, but you have a series of games that are coming back and are going to be in downtown Fresno at the Selden Arena. And Trevor, you've played in that arena now.
Yep.
And what a place.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. I like it. It's a great atmosphere down there. Fans come out to support us, so it's a great place to play.
Awesome. And in the month of January, so you have a game coming up here on the 10th, on Friday the 10th, 11th, 17th of January, the 18th. These are all at Selden Arena?
Yep.
All at Selden Arena. And January 24th at Selden Arena and the 25th. So, an incredible month, the Monsters Hockey back at their home at the Selden Arena. And if you remember, like me as my family, that experience in there, go back and get a taste of it, because all month in January, you have Monsters Hockey at the Cellin Arena. Trevor, a new coach. Talk to me about the team and where things are going, and what do you feel about your team this year?
It's going well. We got a lot of returners from last year. The coach from last year, Kevin Kaminsky, I actually know him. He coached me in Louisiana at the professional ranks. He had a lot of returners coming back that helped us out a lot. So it's we had a good nucleus coming back here from last year. So we added some pieces, and it's going well right now. Like I said, we're in first place in our division. So it's this weekend will be huge, big weekend for us. We're playing in Las Vegas. So it's pretty much to see who can stay in first place here. So it's like I said, it's going to be going to be a couple good grudge matches this weekend.
And how's the Thunderbirds Vegas? How are they doing? Are they tracking pretty good?
They're pretty good. Yeah, they we've played them four times. The first four games of the year, they beat us four times. But I'm saying we got a whole new team here since the last time we've played them. So it's going to be a good test to see where we're at.
So, and that's this Friday night. It's 7:30 is when the match starts down at Cellin Arena. Las Vegas Thunderbirds and the Fresno Monsters. And it's down there, Cellin Arena, at the Fresno Convention Center. So you can get your tickets, go on to FresnoConventionCenter.com, I believe, and you can also go to Monsters, FresnoMonsters.com, and be able to get their tickets to come down there. When you first were here in Fresno and you got your team and you got together and put that together, what is it like? This isn't your first team that you've coached. I'm sure you've had many teams. What was it like coming here to Fresno for the very first time and putting that team together and then now having a team that's leading?
It was different. Like I said, I coached semi-professional hockey for the last 6 years. So when I came here, I've heard nothing but great things about the owner, the organization, the city, the town. You know what I mean? It was different coming here, you know what I mean? But I said, like, we put the team together, and we've came together very well as an organization and as a team from the top to the bottom. And like I said, we're in first place, so we're heading in the right direction. We just want to keep it going.
Keep it going. And the hockey season runs to?
Pretty much April.
April.
Depends how far you go in the playoffs.
So it's perfect time. Get in some hockey before you get in some Fresno Grizzlies.
Yep, exactly.
And then it starts to warm up a little bit. You can come down there and enjoy some Monsters hockey. Growing up, playing hockey, and I'm sure you played hockey and you were in the around it and had bitten by the bug. When did that happen? When were you bit by the bug of hockey?
I started playing hockey when I was 4 years old. So up in Canada, northern Canada, everybody plays. You know what I mean? You have snow out there for about 7-8 months of the year, so it's there's outdoor rinks all over the place, and usually my dad would make a rink out back for us, you know what I mean, so you didn't have to go far. You'd put your skates on in the living room and yeah, head out to the backyard, you know. So it was good. Like I said, then all of a sudden you started playing professional at 20, and I played 11 years of that, and then started coaching and just fell in love with the game.
Where were you in Canada?
I'm from Thunder Bay, Ontario.
Okay, Ontario. Yep. So really cold.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, really cold. Yeah. So that makes sense. You can just go in the backyard and smooth it out, put a little water on it, and you got a skating rink.
Exactly.
Beautiful. And that's common with all kids. It's like going out and playing in the kickball.
Yeah, it's like baseball in America. Everybody plays baseball or football, and up in Canada, everybody plays hockey.
Hockey. The one thing that I love about hockey, and everybody gets a little bit up in arms, is the heated battles.
Yeah.
When they get in those heated battles, and one of the things, I worked in the business of professional wrestling and produced the television, and one of the things we were always told, when there was a real battle backstage, because you have them, and you have two guys are heated, leave them alone, let them get it out of their system. When they hit the ground, pull them apart.
Yep, yeah.
And I remember that, and I was like, is this real hockey rules? And they were like, yeah. That's what they do in hockey. Let them get it out of their system, because if you don't, it's going to get worse.
Yep.
Let it get them out when they hit the ground, so then you make everybody safe, pull them apart.
Yeah, no, that's usually what it's all about. A lot of people ask if it's staged or if it's not, but you know what I mean? Like, a bloody nose isn't staged.
It's so. Not staged, yeah. So you got to let it play its course, because if not, it just pins up and gets worse and
yep.
worse and worse. But the excitement when you're at the Cellin Arena and you're watching Monsters hockey, there's nothing like it. There's nothing like it. The energy and people pounding on the glass, and when someone from the opposing team goes in the penalty box, there's just a lot of energy and a lot of excitement. And even if you like to people watch and just experience it for the very first time, I encourage you to go down and watch Fresno Monsters hockey.
Yeah, no, it gets intense quickly.
It gets intense. What when you played,
A lot of injuries come from hockey.
Yep.
It's a very it's a rough sport on the body. And what do you say to young players that want to play hockey and get into hockey? What's the first thing you tell them? I mean, you've probably experienced a lot and you're growing up in the business. What do you tell young players today if they want to play professionally?
You just want to tell them have fun. Just don't stick to one sport, you know what I mean? Don't play one sport for 12 months of the year, you know what I mean? When hockey's done, go play baseball, go play soccer. You know what I mean? When you're young, you just want to experience a lot more than just that one sport, because you're going to get burned out by the time you turn 16. So play different sports, just have fun at it. You know what I mean? Just take it all in when you can, and then just go from there.
And find out what you love.
Exactly.
And get out there and find out what you love. And that's what's exciting about sports. And my daughter, I was telling you, Zoe, there was a certain time in her life that I think she wanted to play like 6, 7, 8 sports. And we were like, eventually you got to narrow it down to 2. you got to find out those 2 you really like. And but she was, you know, if she could have played football, which she could have, you know, she would do it. Yep. She'd get in there. So I encourage that. You know, you talk to young people and it's like, you got to figure out what you love. It's the same with business.
Yep, exactly.
And I tell people, go intern somewhere. You never know. You might like it. It turns into a career. If you don't experience it, you don't know if you really like it.
Exactly. I totally believe that.
Yeah. So this team, a young team that you have, a lot of new guys?
We got probably about half the team's new guys. You can carry 24 guys. So it's we got 22 guys. We got probably about 10, 12 returners from last year. We got a couple guys that are going to out over age this year. So they're 20 years old. And then we got guys that are basically 16 to 18. So it's we got a good nucleus, good balance of guys. You know what I mean? Look at the guys come back from last year. It's very well. They keep the team going. They keep it running well.
When someone buys a ticket that comes down and watches head coach Trevor and his team take the ice Friday night, what can you promise those people? What are they going to walk away with in the Selden Arena? What are they going to say? You know, I listened to this guy on Talk Radio 1680 KGED, and I haven't watched hockey before, but I had to come out to Selden Arena to see what it was all about. What do you promise they're going to walk out of that building with?
It's going to be good. Like I said, we're a blue collar team. We work hard. We crash and bang all the time. There's going to be a lot of hits. There's usually going to be a couple fights, and you know what I mean. Hopefully, I can guarantee you a win. But like I said, it's going to be a good atmosphere down there, especially playing against Las Vegas. It's going to be a good game. It's for first place, so it's not a weekend that you want to miss.
And the Vegas team, I'm sure, is a very aggressive type
of
team.
Yes, yeah, they're aggressive. They're physical, so then it makes us to be physical. So it's two teams clashing for 60 minutes. You don't know what's going to happen.
And that all starts at 7:30 downtown Fresno at Selden Arena. Again, those tickets can be bought at FresnoConventionCenter.com. You can go to FresnoMonstersHockey, I believe, .com.
Yeah, or you can buy them from the Selden Arena. You can just show up and get them.
Just show up and get them right there, and you can get in there at the Selden Arena. I encourage, if there's any tickets available, go sit on the glass. Go experience what it's like being right there front and center on the glass, because it's pretty exciting.
Yeah, it's nice. It's intense to be down at the ice level there.
Yeah. So, Trevor, we're going to have you back right after this commercial break, and we'll talk a little bit more. I wanted to, as people get to know their head coach of the Monsters Hockey, share something when we come back that maybe someone doesn't know about you. That's a passion, that you're a cook, or you like to play backgammon or whatever it is, so they can find that mutual connection to you. Maybe go up and shake your hand and say, hey, I'm a backgammon fan too, or whatever it is. We'll be right back with more Talk Radio 1680 KGED. I want to remind everybody, Tuesday mornings at 9 a.m., I bring you Business Leaders Live every week, and you can catch this episode and past episodes by going to LanceCardoza.com. We'll be right back with more Business Leaders Live here on Talk Radio 1680 KGED with Trevor, the head coach of Fresno Monsters. We'll be right back. Cool. We're on Facebook Live still. Got to remind everybody. Cool. Oh, it's off a little bit. Oh, it was cutting them off a little. Maybe we bumped it when we were taking the picture.
Oh, right. Yeah. So we're still on Facebook Live.
Yes.
Was it the picture?
Yeah. That's what we were talking about, yeah.
Billet. Billet family is a family that takes play. Like, we have players from all over the world.
Yeah.
So it's not like I said, like, we have a player from Russia comes in, so we have a family that might have an open room or something like that, so we could help the kid come in, so he still basically has, like, a family-oriented place to stay instead of just basically throwing 16 to 20 year olds in a house.
Yeah, exactly.
Family. So these guys, basically by the end of the year, you're like family. These guys bring them in, you know what I mean? Help them cook and stuff like that. So it's huge for us.
It's called Billet Family.
Billet Family.
Billet Family. We'll talk about that when we come back on the air.
Yep.
So you're getting a little sneak preview on Facebook Live. We'll be talking about that here in a moment. We'll talk a little bit about, did you always know you were going to be a hockey player?
From a young age, you always wanted to play hockey. And then once you started becoming more successful at a younger age, you started taking it more seriously. And then once you got a little bit older, 14 to 16, and started getting to the higher ranks of junior hockey, and you realized what you want to do, you know. So it was,
that it sort of molded exactly what you're going with it. So we'll talk a little bit about that, the Billet Family. Anything else when we come back on the radio that we could get in that we want to get in there?
No, like I said, it's 7:30 Friday, Saturday down at Selland Arena. It'd be nice to have everybody down there and pack the arena.
It's Saturday too, the 11th, right?
Yep. Yeah,
Friday, Saturday. And is there any big special promotions going on?
Nope, just come on down. It's going to be a good situation for everybody.
You guys just did the big teddy bear toss,
right? It was huge. We had a huge turnout. We got a lot of teddy bears for kids.
That's always a real big one. Let's talk about that too.
Okay.
And where, you know where they were donated to?
I don't.
I'm not sure. Okay. And if you can... Woody? Oh, he doesn't have his headset on. We'll find out. 90 seconds, we'll be right back. Yeah, I always loved that teddy bear toss.
Yeah, I know. It's a cool event.
My daughter made it was a big deal. We had to figure out what teddy bear. And then she was at that age, too, where it was like very hard to part with what teddy bear it was. But it was always fun. And we'd always go buy a teddy bear. We'd have to buy a couple teddy bears. He's checking right now, so we'll find out. So everybody's listening on Facebook. It's Friday and Saturday. So Monsters Hockey, Selland Arena, and we'll give some more details here shortly. Central Valley Marines Toys for Tots. I think that's the one they've known for years.
Okay.
Yeah. Because the Marines come out, I think, and have picked them up.
Not this year, I don't remember.
Was it? No. Because I've seen it in the years past, they've had some Marines that come out.
Oh, that's nice.
Uniform.
That's cool.
Pretty cool.
You're listening to Business Leaders with Lance Cardoza, the behind-the-scenes story of the business shakers and movers in the Valley and beyond. Once again, here's Lance Cardoza.
Welcome back, everybody. We're here with Business Leaders Live. I bring you Business Leaders Live every Tuesday morning right here at Talk Radio 1680 KGED. In studio, we were talking about Hot Stove. The Hot Stove event with the Fresno Grizzlies will be on January 31st. Back down at Chichansey Park, we had Dr. Jared Mosley, he's the team dentist of the Grizzlies, and he was here talking about the hot stove and being the team dentist. How cool is that to be able to work? I'm sure with Monsters Hockey, they could use a team dentist if you don't already have one.
Yeah, we already got one.
You have one, and so you do need a team dentist because a couple chicklets get knocked loose from time to time.
Yeah, you always need a mouth guard in that sport.
Yes, mouth guards, and we were talking about mouth guards, and that's a... What Dr. Mosley does, which is so great, is all local youth sports. If you need a mouth guard, you can't afford a mouth guard, you can go to Dr. Jared Mosley and they give you a mouth guard.
Nice.
And mold it for you and put that together. So even the kids and with your team dentist, if you needed to partner up with Dr. Mosley, I'm sure he'd be more than happy to help. Athletics are a big thing to him. And so very helpful. But January 31st, you can get your tickets to the Hot Stove. Will Clark, former San Francisco Giant, he'll be on that bill, and former pitching coach Dyre Miller, which the local community loves the man. He was on the phone and from Indianapolis, and Dyre will be here, and be great to see him again, and many others, and a chance to win a Toyota car. So a lot of fun stuff on January 31st. President Derek Franks was also, he sent a message and said that Ryan Scott, a celebrity chef, is going to be there for the event. And that's all happening on January 31st. But this Friday and Saturday, at the Selden Arena. It's monster hockey time at Selden Arena. And you just got done, Trevor, the head coach of the Grizzlies. You just got, or sorry, head coach of the Monsters Hockey. Got to keep it all straight. with your teddy bear toss.
Yep.
Anybody who's been to a hockey game, they've been to from when it was the Falcons, from when it was Monsters Hockey, that teddy bear toss is pretty cool.
Yeah, it was a huge event. Like I said, we had, I don't even know, I'd say there has to be over 1,000 teddy bears that were thrown on the ice, you know what I mean? So it goes to a good cause. And for the kids that can't afford a teddy bear, so I mean, we bring them out there and hand them out to them. So it's, like I said, it's a good event for all ages.
And the Central Valley Marines, Toys for Tots, collect all those teddy bears and get them to those kids. And it is a cool event. I mean, like I said, with my daughter, you'd see all these teddy bears just flying over the glass, flying onto the ice. Did they still have, Trevor, do they still have a Chuck-a-Puck?
Oh, yeah, there's Chuck-a-Puck every game.
Chuck-a-Puck is so cool.
Yeah, every game you see the kids out there trying to hit the center ice, and half the proceeds go to them and half the proceeds go to the team. So it's a good event.
Awesome. And the Chuck-a-Puck is a little rubber puck, a little soft puck. It was like a foam thing, and they got a number on it. You buy these Chuck-a-Pucks as the donation.
Yeah.
And at a certain time in the match throughout the night, you get to hit these rings in the center of the ice, and there's this little bitty one in the middle. But if it rolls and lands in that dot in the center, and it's funny to just listen to the crowd pop and just get so excited as one will roll and just pass the bullseye.
Yeah,
it almost fell in the spot, you know, and then the one hits and the crowd goes crazy.
Yeah, there's no strategy to that. There's just pucks bouncing all over the place, and all of a sudden one just bounces the right way and lands on the center ice, and they're the winner.
And I've seen one hit, like, in a corner of the ice, over the glass, going, there's no way it's even, and roll all the way there and land on that dot.
Yeah, it's like I said, there's no strategy.
No
to it.
Strategy.
It's all luck.
It's like a carnival game out there.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of fun at Monsters Hockey, and this Friday and Saturday, you can get your tickets by going down to Selden Arena, Fresno Convention Center, go Monsters Hockey online, search them Google, and you'll be able to enjoy this hockey match against Vegas. You have Vegas both nights, right? Friday
yep.
and Saturday. A lot of fun. Let's talk about, we briefly during the break, we were talking about these young players when they come in. They're pretty young.
Yeah, 16 to 20 years old.
16, 20 years old. So they would need to stay with families, and we were talking about that. We call it billet
families. Yeah, billet families.
And how does that work for the
We have, like I said, we have great billet families. They help the team out huge. They take kids in. Like I said, we have players from Russia, Slovakia, all over the world. So, like, players will come in and billet families offer their house to us and to the players. So the players will come in and they kind of keep the family-oriented situation for the players. So they're not, you know, I mean, you're 16 years old, you're going to be missing your family. So by the end of the year, these players are pretty much family. Like, it's they get great bonds, great roots to each other and to the family. So it's good. It helps the team out huge, and obviously it helps the players out a lot.
And you probably are looking for billet families from time to time as the seasons come through, and someone can always contact you guys to.
Yeah, you can always contact the Fresno Monsters office there down at Gateway, and like I said, we have great support throughout the community and from the billet family, so it's greatly appreciated.
Awesome, and it's called a billet family. So if it's something that you want to give back, I think if professional baseball does it too with keeping players. I remember. Buster Posey, the night he got called up, I think he was rooming like with two or three guys at a house. And next thing he knows, he's a World Series champion and came right here from Fresno, you know, and one phone call away. Hockey, and it's a long road. It's not like two or three levels. There's many years, I think, of groundwork, I think, with every sport.
Yeah.
But when you got into it, did you always know you were going to do hockey, that hockey was your thing?
Yeah, like I said, when you're 14 to 16 years old, you're at the higher levels of the junior ranks, and you're getting drafted to be at the higher levels of the junior ranks. So then you start playing with guys that have played in the NHL during the summertime when you're playing with them. So you kind of compare yourself to them, and you realize that you don't want to do the 9-to-5. So you're like, we're going to give this a go here. Then you realize that you're successful at it, and you go for it.
Yeah, and there's nothing like getting paid to play.
Yeah.
And having a good time.
Yeah, you can't complain. It's a great sport.
So so as a young guy, you knew you were going to be in this business of hockey.
Yeah, like I said, you just always wanted to push for it. You know what I mean? I had an older brother, and you know what I mean? I just always wanted to follow what he did. So when you're younger and you're playing with the older guys, you had to make sure you were good enough to play. So when you got older, you know what I mean, you were playing with your skill sets as a higher level. So it was always good. You always knew what you wanted to do. You know what I mean? Like I said, you don't want to just play one sport for 12 months of the year. So then once you come back after a few months of missing hockey, you know, I mean, you're right dedicated to it.
And I'm going to attempt your last name. Kasarich?
Karazowicz.
Karazowicz. Karazowicz.
Yeah.
Close. Trevor Karazowicz. And the head coach, Monsters Hockey. And so your brother played as well. So you got to see your brother and falling in his footsteps and saying, I'm going to be really good at this game.
Yeah, just when you, like I said, when you're a younger kid, you always want to do what your older brother wanted to do. So when you're 5-6 years younger than him, you know, when you're playing it with kids that are 5-6 years older, and you had to adapt, and you had to adapt quickly, or they weren't going to let you play.
So as a young guy, did you ever have an aspiration? Did everything click? Like, I wanted to be a fireman or a policeman or anything else that ever maybe strayed you a little bit, but it was always hockey?
Yeah, no, you just always wanted to play hockey. In Northern Canada, that's all it is. Everybody just wants to play hockey, and it's just when you're a young kid, you just always want to be out on the ice.
And to be able to have that opportunity to make a career out of it and come here to Fresno, head coach of Monsters Hockey, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, no, it's very cool. I'm grateful for everything from the sport.
So we're going to take a short break. When we come back, Trevor, we're going to share that bit of knowledge. And, we'll wrap up. We got to wrap up here. Sorry. What's something real quick that someone doesn't know about you?
Not too much. Just love the sport of hockey and grateful to be in Fresno.
I lost time here. Business Leaders Live is wrapping up. Thank you, Trevor. Monsters Hockey, Friday and Saturday night. You got to come out and join it. We'll be back next Tuesday morning. With all the chaos today's show, I forgot we're at the final segment. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
Appreciate it. Appreciate you coming in.
Yep.
We'll take a quick picture. We'll put it on our website.
Okay.
Yeah, I get a photo. Yeah. Okay. My family out. We'll come out and check it out.
Thanks,
all right, thank you so much. All right.